You say, well, okay, explain that a little bit more. Why did God deal with Abraham based on faith? The book of Romans, early on, actually a little earlier in Romans, Paul goes on talking about how the Gentiles respond to God because his law is written on their hearts. Meaning, every human heart, it's amazing, you know, no matter where you go in the world, people have this concept called ought to. Now just think about that. Now we know what we do, but we also know what we ought to do. And this ought to is the law God writes on every human's heart. So no matter what village you're born in, you know you ought not just punch somebody. You know you ought not just take something that doesn't belong, right? Okay, so we got that, right? So God dealt with Abraham through what I'm going to call the law of common decency written on each person's heart. Now, today it's getting rarer and rarer, but this law of common decency says if something is shown to be true, we ought to believe it. So when God impressed his existence and his character upon Abraham's heart, Abraham didn't cancel him, didn't fight with him. When Abraham saw the truth, he trusted him. Faith is simply embracing truth and doing it from the heart. Verse 17. And he continues, as it is written, I have made you a father of many nations. Now, the way I'm dissecting the verses, it may be a little bit hard to follow here, but I'm going to go to Genesis 17 in just a couple moments. But God basically said, Abraham, I'm going to make you the father. The father of many nations, in the presence of whom he believed. So in Genesis 17:5, when God promised that Abraham would be the father of many nations, Abraham's response was simply to believe. Okay, again, if something is shown to be true, the proper response is to believe it. Now, you may not realize this, but what we choose to believe and not believe is actually a moral choice. And this is why we will answer to God for our beliefs. There are some things I don't believe just because I don't want to believe. Not because I've not been convinced, not because I see evidence, because I don't like it. What we believe and what we don't believe is a moral choice. And it is a choice God's going to hold us accountable for. When the sun rises and sets, and you see the beauty, and you see the way things are organized, you see the design in creation. You know, the stars have been talking to you every night. Everything about the planet has been saying there's a God. But if you choose to go in another direction, you might say, well, I don't see the evidence, but God says, I know you have made a choice. And this is why, you know, as we sung that song, our hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. Each of us who sang those lyrics at some point have made a choice. The Holy Spirit, maybe it was through a minister teaching or maybe, I don't know, something hits you as you watch this a sunrise. But it's God was striking your heart saying, I'm out here. And I'm for you, and I love you. And in that moment, you had a choice to believe or disbelieve.
I'm so glad you joined me for this special teaching of God's Word. It's my sincere prayer that you learn something new about God that changed your life forever. Please be sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the bell for our new content. And we upload new stuff every week. Also, it's with the help of folks like yourself that we can bring the teaching of God's word to people around the DMV as well as around the world. So simply put, we cannot do it alone. So please take a moment to partner with us to help bring this life-changing gospel to even more people. Getting started is easy. Just go to gracechurchva.org/give. And as always, thank you for your support and thank you for helping us advance the kingdom of God.